In this video, we're going to be covering how to draw the shear force and bending moment diagrams for a simply supported beam with a UDL and a point load. By the end of this video, you'll be able to draw the shear force and bending moment diagrams for a beam and use this knowledge to solve similar problems. Let's start by answering what are shear force and bending moments. Shear force is the force that acts perpendicular to the longitudinal axis of the beam. It tends to cause the beam to slide or shear apart at a particular section. It is denoted as F and can act upwards and downwards. A bending moment happens when there is a distance between the applied force and the point in which the moment is acting. It is calculated by multiplying the force by the distance. It results in the beam bending about the point. It is denoted as M and can either act clockwise or anti-clockwise. The shear force diagram shows the variation of the shear force along the length of the beam. The vertical axis represents the magnitude of the shear force, and the horizontal axis represents the length of the beam. The diagram is typically shown with positive values of shear force above the horizontal axis, and negative values below the axis. Similar to the shear force diagram, the bending moment diagram shows the variation of the bending moment along the length of the beam. The vertical axis represents the magnitude of the bending moment, and the horizontal axis represents the length of the beam. Again, the diagram is typically shown with positive values above the horizontal axis and negative values below the axis. Now, let's work through an example of how to draw the shear force and bending moment diagrams for a beam with a UDL and a point load. If we look at the beam, we can see that it is 6 meters in length and has supports at either end labeled RA and RB. We already know that RA equals 340 newtons and RB equals 260 newtons. If you need help calculating these, please watch our video on how to calculate the support reactions of a beam with a UDL and a point load. To do this, either click the link in the top right of the video or follow the link in the video description box. Thank you. Anyway, back to our beam. The beam has a point load of 240 newtons 2 meters from the left. It also has a uniformly distributed load of 60 newtons per meter applied across the whole beam. In order to draw our diagrams, we must make imaginary cuts along the beam where we are going to determine our shear force and bending moments. In both instances, we'll take into consideration the forces to the left of our cuts. It must be noted that as our beam is in equilibrium, the total forces acting on the beam are zero, and the total moments are also zero. We'll begin by drawing the shear force diagram. First, we need to cut the beam at sections where we want to determine the shear force. In this example, we'll cut the beam at 2 meter intervals. To calculate the shear force for the UDL, we'll multiply W by the distance x to the left of the cut. When x equals 0, the only force acting on the beam is the 340 newton reaction force RA, so the shear force at the start of the beam goes from 0 to positive 340 newtons on our diagram. When x equals 2, we still have the 340 newton reaction force RA, but we also have the introduction of the 60 newton per meter UDL spanning 2 meters in the opposite direction. We must start by calculating this before we consider the point load, as it has already acted on the beam for the previous 2 meters to the left of our cut. So the initial shear force at this point is calculated by 340 minus 60 times 2, which equals 220 newtons. As mentioned, we also have the 240 newton point load in the downward direction. For this, we can easily subtract 240 from 220, which leaves us with minus 20 newtons. So, the shear force at this point begins at positive 220 newtons because of the UDL, and goes to minus 20 newtons because of the point load. When x equals 4, we take into consideration all the forces to the left of the cut. We have the 340 newton reaction force RA, the 60 newton per meter UDL spanning 4 meters, and the 240 newton point load. Therefore, the shear force at this point is calculated by 340 minus 60 times 4 minus 240, which equals minus 140 newtons. Finally, when x equals 6, the UDL now spans the whole length of the beam. Again, taking into consideration all the forces to the left of our cut, the starting point for the shear force is 340 minus 60 times 6 minus 240 newtons, which equals minus 260 newtons. We also have the reaction force RB of 260 newtons in the positive direction. So the shear force at this point goes from minus 260 to 0 newtons on our diagram. By connecting the dots, we get the finished shear force diagram for our beam, which looks like this. The diagram shows how the shear force acting on the beam changes along its length, and also identifies the point of maximum shear stress when the line crosses the neutral axis. This is found to be at the 2 meter point. Next, we'll look at how to draw the bending moment diagram for the same beam. This time we'll be making cuts at 1 meter intervals to achieve a more accurate graph. As a bending moment is equal to a force times distance, the formula for the UDL is Wx times x over 2. This is because the UDL W spans the distance x, but is considered to act about the centroid of the portion, which is in the middle. When x equals 0, the only force acting on the beam is the reaction force Ra, but as it has a distance of 0 meters, the bending moment is equal to 0. So our diagram starts at 0 Newton meters. When x equals 1, the reaction force Ra now has a distance of 1 meter, and we have the introduction of the UDL. So the bending moment becomes 340 times 1 minus 60 times 1 times 1 over 2, which equals 310 Newton meters. When x equals 2, the reaction force Ra now has a distance of 2 meters, and the span of the UDL is also 2 meters. We have the introduction of the 240 Newton point load, but as the distance at this point is 0, it does not cause a moment. So, our bending moment becomes 340 times 2 minus 60 times 2 times 2 over 2, which equals 560 Newton meters. When x equals 3, the distance of Ra is 3 meters, and the span of the UDL is also 3 meters. At this point, the 240 Newton point load has a distance of 1 meter. So our bending moment is 340 times 3 minus 60 times 3 times 3 over 2 minus 240 times 1, which equals 510 Newton meters. When x equals 4, Ra now has a distance of 4 meters, and the UDL also has a span of 4 meters. The 240 Newton point load now has a distance of 2 meters. So the bending moment at this point is 340 times 4 minus 60 times 4 times 4 over 2 minus 240 times 2, which equals 400 Newton meters. When x equals 5, Ra has a distance of 5 meters, and the UDL has a span of 5 meters. The 240 Newton point load now has a distance of 3 meters. So, our bending moment is given by 340 times 5 minus 60 times 5 times 5 over 2 minus 240 times 3, which equals 230 Newton meters. Finally, when x equals 6, Ra has a distance of 6 meters, and the UDL spans the whole beam. The 240 Newton point load has a distance of 4 meters. The reaction force Rb is not considered at this point, as it has a distance of 0 meters. Therefore, our bending moment is 340 times 6 minus 60 times 6 times 6 over 2 minus 240 times 4, which equals 0 Newton meters. By connecting the dots, we get the finished bending moment diagram for our beam, which looks like this. The curvature of the graph indicates that if we had calculated more points along the beam, our graph would have had a smooth curve. We can also identify the point of maximum bending moment when the graph reaches its peak. And that's it. Thank you for watching. We hope you enjoyed this video showing you how to draw the shear force and bending moment diagrams for the simply supported beam with a UDL and a point load. Please check the channel for similar engineering related content.